Okay. All right, we're going to get started. Is it going? We good? All right. We're going to get started. My name is Greg Hetrick. This is SecIC 101. So first off, what is SecIC? It's a CitySec, which is a group of unaffiliated informal meetups, like-minded security professionals. CitySec groups meet to discuss topics of interest, non-work, non-vendor setting. We meet the fourth Wednesday of every month, and we are a registered 501c3. Weirdness. I broke it. All right, we're good. We're good? How's that? All right. We have a disclaimer. We try and keep everything PG-13. I had a list of how many times I could say shit in PG-13, but I can't remember what it was, so I'll just keep saying it. Code of conduct. What's it? It's twice? I have two left. Shit. Code of conduct. Don't be an ass. SecIC board members have the final say what that is. Just kind of be nice to everybody. It's a smaller group tonight, so that shouldn't be a problem. challenge ideas, not people, which we stole from SecESM, who stole from SecAC. Okay, business in the front, party in the back. So pizza's on the side, beer, soda, lemonade, water, back there. Our sponsor tonight is B-Sides Iowa. I also happen to be the lead for B-Sides Iowa, so I gave everybody tonight a preview of what our shirts look like, because we just got the designs back from the printer today, and so I thought I'd show them off. They're like a military green, I think is what they're called. They're the super nice soft cotton like we had last year. Anyway, that's what they look like. Oh, if anybody's... What's that? Yeah, my wife gets really pissed when they're like more black t-shirts come home, and so everybody's like, God, just don't make it black. So last year it was like a gray, so this year we tried something even different. If you're interested in sponsoring, secic.org/sponsor, or, you know, hit one of us up. Mostly Zach, but he's not here. Tonight's agenda, 101, which is now, news. And then Matt's going to give a threat intelligence talk. Typically, we have two talks. Matt's is pretty long because he likes to listen to himself talk. So we're just going to have one tonight. Next month agenda, how to scrape by on $500K a year. For those who don't get the joke, like CNBC posted something like, here's a family that is average and they're broke and they make $500K a year. But if you like really read the line items, they live in a $1.5 million house. They drive like a BMW 5 Series and a Land Cruiser. And they spend like 10 grand a year in clothes. Like it was completely freaking ridiculous. Yeah, violin lessons, and I mean, it was like 18 grand in charitable contributions. Like, and then they at the end of the year, they only have $7,500 left over. Screw you. Anyway, so if nobody else submits a talk, I'm going to give that talk. Otherwise, feel free to submit a talk. Hit one of us up in the Slack channel. I mean, it doesn't have to be something that's ready for DEF CON. It, you know, it can be 15 minutes. You know, this cool thing I'm working on, you know, that sort of thing. So think about it. Oh, I guess we have a slide for that. We want you. here's your board members. So Zach's out tonight, and I don't think Brandon's here tonight, which is cool, but the rest of us are here. That's how you can get a hold of us. I think contact goes to all of us. Anyway, if you hit us up, Twitter, YouTube, we're never going to get a vanity domain because Google sucks, but Bitly's nice. All right, so I updated this. Come chat with over 108 InfoSec professionals because there's 109 in the channel. If you want to join, if you want to join our Slack channel, just hit Slack on our website, sign up, and I guess you profit. I haven't seen any money yet. Upcoming events: CypherCon, 11th and 12th. I think there's some folks from Des Moines going. Are you going, Matt? Matt's going. There's also KernelCon, which isn't on here. It's in Omaha. I don't know if anybody's going or not, but that's their inaugural event. Should be pretty cool. It's in downtown Omaha, down at the Embassy Suites by the river, which is a really cool place. You should check them out. Besides Iowa's April 20th, and Circle City Con is the 31st through the 2nd in Indianapolis, and we always, there's a pretty good chunk of folks who go out there every year. So if you guys want events and cons, usually there's ride sharing, room sharing, all that stuff floating around. Scholarship. So we work with SecDSM. Anytime either group wins a black badge at one of the conferences, they go into our scholarship fund, and then students can apply to get one of those to get free entry into an event. We have, do we have Circle City Con ones? GurCon, Wild West Hack and Fest, ThoughtCon. Anyway, they're all up there, so you can put them in. We have plenty to Wild West Hack and Fest now. So if anybody wants to go to that, that's a great event. It's October, towards the end of October. All right, Merchmonger. It says wait, it's me, but it's not really, but I'll do it anyway. So we have patches, $5 a piece, SecIC blockchains. If you're new, get a sticker. Anything else? What's that? Stickers free. Yep. $5 for blockchain. Suggest donation for a patch is $5. All right. Okay. You have to extract the blockchain from them. Yeah. The blockchains are like Christmas tree lights, so yeah. It's like a carnival prize. If you can get it out and give us $5, you get to keep it. All right, next up, financial transparency. Oh wait. We have a slide for that too, I guess. Why is that blank? Oh, you're gonna flip through it. Here, you want that? It's mine. But if you guys want to use it.
All right, so it looks like we have a couple new folks tonight. So every month we go through our financials. We are a 501c3 nonprofit. So we'll go ahead and run through those. So the previous balance last month was $1,000. The expenses we had, okay, that's wrong. That should say February. I took this from an old one. Was $145. Last month in income, we had $0. So if you can do some pretty tricky math, that puts us at $855. Two things to keep in mind for this. The pizza is always a month behind, and we did have a sponsor this month. I didn't include it because it hasn't been deposited in the bank account yet. So stay tuned for that next month. And with that, there is the graph. So let's go ahead and jump into the news. We're going to get the big ones out of the way first. So ASUS has admitted that their live update utility was backdoored by an APT group and a supply chain attack. Kaspersky was the vendor, I guess you could say, that discovered it last year, and then or this year, and then they're the ones that came out and disclosed what was going on. ASUS has released two things. There's a download that you can run on your system, and it'll say if you were affected by it, or the number I saw last was 600 specific MAC addresses. They had a website where you could put your MAC address in there, and it would say if you were targeted or not. The bottom slide on the right, you can see by country. This is from Kaspersky's number, so it's not everything. Keep in mind who, what countries were targeted in that. Correct. Yeah, ASUS came out and they said they weren't even going to disclose it, and then finally Kaspersky came out and said, "Hey, no, this is real. This happened. You know, this actually happened." And then, yeah, Motherboard, yep, came out and did that. Thank you. So, next big one of the previous month, there's a new ransomware, new-ish, that came out in January called Locker Goga. It completely stopped an aluminum producer, Norsk Hydro, and they at one point they were saying that they were just going to purchase all new computers for their network. So far, they've said that as far as victims, the group who discovered it, Malware Hunter Team, said that so far they know about dozens. This is about the third or fourth one. The previous one that made the news was the Altran Technologies. And on the left, you can see typically with ransomware, they'll leave you a note, like a text file. That's what that specific one looks like. And then this was on their door. I don't know if you can read it. But it says basically, please do not connect any device to the Hydro network. Do not turn on any device connected to the Hydro network. Please disconnect any device, phone, tablet, etc. from the Hydro network. Await new update security. So, yes. So, is there a way to put my notes on here? I have that in my notes. How do I do that? So, go ahead.
It was entirely manual. The malware doesn't have last I read was that researchers believed that the threat actor group had domain level admin and used Active Directory and inserted malware using
And group policy.
It's a really interesting malware because the malware itself doesn't copy.
Right. That's it. Yes, that's exactly what I read as well. Right. It would. Yep. It was even like encrypting like system files. It was, from what I've read in certain reports, like sometimes certain workstations wouldn't even boot up. So like it, like Matt said, it's not very sophisticated now. Who knows? They might develop it. But yeah, it's still like, again, it's still fairly new. The first sighting that's been disclosed was in January. So that's something to keep your eye out. Between now and the last meeting, CoinHive, if you're familiar with them, they said that they were going to shut down their service. And if you're not familiar with CoinHive, typically in a crypto jacking attack, so let's say you take your browser, you visit a certain website. If that website's been compromised, or even if you're the owner of the website, and instead of running ads or running it alongside ads, it will then start mining cryptocurrency on your workstation. Well, this was a service that basically did all that for you. They gave you the JavaScript, you put in like a token, they would do all the hard work for you, and then they would, I don't know exactly what their cut was, but they would then send you a specified amount. So the reason that they stopped it was they said that the drop in hash rate was over 50% after the last Monero hard fork, so that hit them really hard. And then they also said that Monero had been depreciating over 85% within a year. So I'm curious, and maybe someone from the audience may or may not agree, with this shutting down, we're likely to see less crypto jacking attacks after, and then maybe we'll see more ransomware or other types of attacks. Something that's...
They had like 80% of the market, so that means there's a 20% of the market that someone else had that's now a majority holder.
Okay. Well, there you go.
If anything, it's going to be the fork and the drop in Monero value that's going to drive it away.
Right. Yeah, just like this. And then you can see the GIF on the right. This actually most everyone in here has seen it. The spike when the browser has the crypto jacking website loaded. And then you should see it go down. There you go, right there. Okay, the fourth. So does anyone here play Counter-Strike 1.6? So according to Dr. Webb, they said that there was a specific botnet, the Bolinard Trojan botnet, was using Counter-Strike 1.6 servers to distribute their malware. And so it affected Windows systems. And it said at its peak, 39% of all Counter-Strike servers were being used to distribute that malware. They were able to figure out the DGA behind that, and they worked with that reg.ru, and they were able to stop that. But from what I had read, I mean, Counter-Strike 1.6 is over 20 years old. There's no new patches or anything coming out for it, but people still play it. So, I don't know, just something to keep in mind if you're still a Counter-Strike player. And then finally, there was a Lithuanian who was involved in a BEC fraud attack. They were able to steal over $100 million from Google and Facebook. So what their attack was, they set up a businesses with a business or businesses with like-named companies that those two companies used, and they would send them invoices, and then Facebook, Google, they're like, oh, we know this company, this is normal, blah, blah, blah. They updated the bank accounts that were used, and then that's how they received the funds. It's a fairly common attack, but the surprising thing about this one is how much money that single individual was able to steal from those two companies. That is him waiting to be extradited, and if he is charged and convicted, he could face up to 30 years in jail. So, finally, before we take a little break and go to the talk for tonight, for the new people, we do have a segment on jobs. So if you're looking for a job or if your company is hiring, go ahead, shout them out, come up front, let us know. Is anybody hiring right now? Yes? Ryan Stillian's still hiring? Okay, anybody else hiring? Anybody else looking? Now's your chance. This is a great time if you're looking because we have people hiring. No? All right, then on that end, we'll go ahead, take a short break. Please get some pizza. There's quite a bit left. And then go ahead, grab a beer. Don't forget to tip your bartender, and the talk will be up shortly. Thank you.